UPDF troops revolt in Equatorial Guinea. A simmering conflict between the contingent commander and his legion of Ugandan soldiers deployed in Equatorial Guinea to maintain peace threatens to erupt into a full-fledged public catastrophe. Soldiers from Ugandan military and mentoring team, UMTMTV, have threatened to abandon the top contingent commander, Colonel James Kato Kalyebara, who they accuse of abuse, discrimination, and short-temperedness. The soldiers plan to revolt against the commander because their repeated appeals for support to Ugandan bosses have gone unanswered. We also learned that officials in the oil-rich country sought in vain to explain the Ugandan commander's actions. The troops want the Ugandan army to rein in the insensitive commander. The source stated that if not addressed quickly, the current issue could lead to a diplomatic crisis and jeopardize the deployment of Ugandan troops in Equatorial Guinea. The president, first family, and other vital primary locations, and to mentor Guinean armed troops. Several reports regarding the commander have been made to top security institutions in Uganda, but no action has been taken. Since early this year, they have only received two Ugandan investigators. When Colonel Deus Ndiabagi and Major Dickens Kanyore of the land forces in Bombo traveled to Equatorial Guinea on April 14, 2021, sources suggest no extensive investigations were performed. When they arrived, the commander compromised them. Instead than spending more time with the troops to find out the truth behind our grievances, said sources. The troops demand a second independent investigation. The UMTMTV is required to have 250 personnel, however, two soldiers were deported to Uganda on May 22, 2021. On May 5, 2021, five troops in the Malabo sector allegedly escaped and drank late at night. Unknown attackers attacked them. Soldiers are still unhappy with their colleagues' return. They said the commander's judgments are mostly based on rumors. To explain his dramatic decisions, the troops accuse the commander of constructing rival reporting structures with no information. Just 5 months into the assignment, the commander of Malabo sector, Major Jeffrey Mulongo, was suspended pending repatriation. Sources say Mulongo has never been warned verbally or in writing by the commander about his suspension. However, sources told The Observer that Mulongo was arrested at the airport and is now in Bombo. Major Johnson Tumwesije also flew back. The tank component commander Tumwesije was the Mongomo sector commander. Tumwesije's only job in the mission was to supervise the tanks. Six combat tanks operate in the Bada and Mongomo areas of Equatorial Guinea. Tumwesije was fine with the single duty, but repatriation was certainly unfair. The troops dislike Colonel Kalyebara's divisive politics. Those who do not obey his hardline orders are dubbed National Unity Platform, Bobi Wine, members, NUP. Soldiers in the three areas believed their commander would engage in cordial discussions with them, but he rarely visits them. Kalyebara has only visited these other sectors when changing sector commanders, officers, and soldiers. In the Mongomo sector, soldiers rushed away from him, the sources stated. During one visit, the commander was accused of transferring officers based on personal interests. Kalyebara is currently without an investigative officer, logistician, or political commissar at the Troop Task Force headquarters in Bada sector. The commander has appointed four administrative officials but has failed to work with them. However, it has never explained why the intended candidate is still in Uganda, a source said the mission region lacks armored and artillery soldier accommodation. Sources say soldiers are staying in old tents from prior batches. The troops also want a probe into a missing handgun N0. CP-15589 and how it magically returned to the Bada headquarters armory. Sergeant Edson Munday, the army officer, Corporal Robert Tusimi, the task force commander's ADC, and Sergeant Richard Obwoki, the armory custodian are the main suspects. On June 5, 2021, the task force arms officer, Sergeant Edson Munday, allegedly slept outside the camp with the armory keys, leaving soldiers without guns all night. The pistol went missing during this audit, prompting an investigation. 7 days later, the missing pistol was discovered wrapped in a piece of cloth in the armory. Obuoki was eventually exonerated by the commander following an apology from him and his ADC Tusimi, since he only possessed the armory keys, notwithstanding the discontent of other soldiers.